Give everybody time to gather. Good morning, everyone. Today is the 100th anniversary of the Nativity of Pope St. John Paul the Great, the birth of John Paul II. So we have the treat of Mass in Polish this morning, celebrated by our Father Kosk. Please join us as best as you can, and I thank you for your attendance today.
Ty Pana na wejście, Pan zawarł z nim przymierze pokoju i ustanowił go pasterzem, aby posiadł godność kapłańską na zawsze. W imię Ojca i Syna i Ducha Świętego.
Amen.
Miłość Boga Ojca, łaska Pana naszego Jezusa Chrystusa i dar jedności w Duchu Świętym. Niech będą z wami wszystkimi i z Duchem Twoim.
Today we celebrate the Votive Mass to commemorate the great saint John Paul the Great. You know, of course, that he was a Polish, and today I celebrate this Mass in my native language and also native language of this say great saint. That will be a little bit different, but how you can be with me spiritually and pray how you can. I offer this Mass for
Bob and Jolene Wiegard.
Yes. Uznajmy przed Bogiem, że jesteśmy grzeszni, abyśmy mogli z czystym sercem złożyć najświętszą ofiarę. prowadzi nas do życia wiecznego. Amen. Módlmy się. Boże, bogaty w miłosierdzie swojej woli, święty Jan Paweł II, papież, kierował całym Kościołem. Spraw prosimy, abyśmy dzięki Jego nauczaniu z ufnością otworzyli nasze serca na działanie zbawcze łaski Chrystusa, jedynego odkupiciela człowieka, który z Tobą żyje i króluje w jedności Ducha Świętego, Bóg przez wszystkie wieki wieku.
Of the Apostles. We set sail from Troas, making a straight run for Samothrace, and on the next day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, a leading city in that district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We spent some time in that city. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate along the river, where we thought there would be a place of prayer. We sat and spoke with the women who had gathered there. One of them, a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, a worshiper of God, listened. And the Lord opened her heart to pay attention to what Paul was saying. After she and her household had been baptized, she offered us an invitation. If you consider me a believer in the Lord, come and stay at my home. And she prevailed on us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all his faithful. Alleluia.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to God.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. And you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have told you this so that you may not fall away. They will expel you from the synagogues. In fact, the hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think he is offering worship to God. They will do this because they have not known either the Father or me. I have told you this so that when your hour comes, you may remember that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Szczęść Boże. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
The homily will be not in Polish. Do not discourage you to watching it. And today, we have this great feast of Nativity of Saint John Paul the Great. For all my life, I think he was one of my greatest patrons. When he died in 2005, I was very sad, and I was just 11 at this time, and I remember I just started to cry. My mom said, "Go to the church because there are people are gathering there to pray." So I went. That was about 10 o'clock in the evening, and you know, my soul were hard because I lost somebody who was dear to me and very close to me. Even though I was so young, I really liked and loved at this time Pope John Paul II. His life from the beginning wasn't easy. I would say it was very hard to live for him. His mom died when he was very young, then his brother, and after he finished his seminary, his dad passed away. And similar as I, his ordination were in very small number of people, just few people underground, because there was a war during this time. And my ordination just 10 people, and his ordination just few people, even less than mine. So I feel very similar to him at this time and during the ordination. And I also play in theater, so he loved to do it the same. I was doing this for 10 years almost, and I enjoyed this. So many people were talking, "Oh, you're similar to St. John Paul II. Pope John Paul II, so maybe you will become a priest." So, you know, at some point of time I started to think about it. And during my life, and then when I discovered that God is calling me, I always ask Him to pray for me as a great intercession. And He intercedes for us, I think, a lot. His whole life was directed to Mary. Even his motto was "Totus tuus," all yours, Mary. And this is very important for us in this country, especially when we have a lot of Protestants, our brothers and sisters, and they really don't believe that Mary was a mother of God. She was just a woman who gave birth, and they don't really worship her and don't pray to her, but we have to pray for her because she is so close to her son as every mother is. So pray for her, to her, through her, to Jesus. We have to remember that we always pray through some saint or Mary to Jesus, to God. Saint John Paul II left a lot of good works, writings, which we are obligated now to read and to reflect on it. He said one time that you are clapping to me, but you have to listen to me. This is more important. So we sometimes even are forgetting his teaching and what he was telling us during these many years of his papal service. So I encourage everyone and myself to take a look on some writings of him, because they are very good. Maybe they are not easy to read, but when we think about it, it will become easier. And today we hear again about the journeys of apostles and Saint Paul. And we hear that when they were preaching and worshiping God in the front of the synagogue, some people were gathering, and Jesus, choosing us, he is also opening our hearts to his teaching. And he opened the heart of the Lydia woman. And that is very important to us, that we have to try to open our hearts to the words of God. And also the opening our hearts for what we can experience here in this world. Like John Paul II experienced the closeness of Mary when he was shot by this man in May 13, 1981. And this is a very significant date, because the first appearance of Mary in Fatima was at this day, in 1917. And she was, like he said, he felt that she was close to him and she protected him because she had a greater mission to do later. And his mission was to proclaim the divine mercy. And he did that. He said the second Sunday of Easter, the Divine Mercy Sunday. And this is important because he even died in the vigil of the second Sunday of Easter. And this is significant that we have to be careful and listen to the signs which God or the saints are giving us. And we hear also from the Gospel, again, about the Holy Spirit, as we are preparing to receive this great gift of Pentecost. When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. And you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. So we all testify about Jesus, but the Holy Spirit is working in the world, and he is working through us to others. So, as I said on Sunday, we have to be open and ask Holy Spirit to guide us, to lead us in this world, how we can say the truth about Jesus Christ. And John Paul was a great example how he testifies about the great works of Jesus in his life and how he understand the Holy Scriptures and how he was teaching people about the love. And he showed the love for young people, for sick people. He created the World Youth Day. We can talk about John Paul a lot and for a long time. But what is the most important, that he showed us through his life how to be a patient, how to listen to the God's words, how to be strong even during the difficult times, during the different illnesses, how he struggled for many years when he was sick. This is a very great example for all of us. And I'm very happy to be Polish. We have this great Polish saint. But this is not important from which country we are. It's important what we have in our hearts, what we can give to other people. And even he was from the far country, as he said on the beginning, he was showing love to everyone. He had so many pilgrimages around the world, and he always showed respect and love to others. It doesn't matter which color, which nationality, he always was with those people, with love and caring for them. So, as we celebrate his birth, 100th anniversary, ask him to intercede for us, that he will help us to understand what are the signs from God in our vocation, to the priesthood or marriage, how we can understand them and how we can proclaim the gospel like the apostles to all the world. Oh, some Polish artists this year prepared beautiful song about John Paul II in his 100th anniversary. I will not sing it, it's too complicated. But I will read some phrases from it, which very clever are showing the example of John Paul. A white pilgrim walks a dark path among the clouds. He hears the planet Earth praying for a miracle. Yearning rings like a silver bell, all the roses of the world are yours. Because no one will replace you, you open the door to the light. The spirit came into our hearts. A miracle happened. The fear disappeared. You told us to go with hope. Santo subito, you at least. The spirit came into our hearts. A miracle happened. The fear disappeared. At airports around the globe, crowds strain their eyes to see you kiss the ground of their lands. We miss you now, year after year, like fatherless children in the dark. You told us to go with hope. Santo subito, you at least. The spirit came into our hearts. A miracle happened. The fear disappeared. Because no one will replace you. We are missing this great Pope, but we are wishing him happy birthday. He probably doesn't need it, but I love him so much. By the intercession of Saint John Paul II, we pray God in all our intentions. For all the baptized, that we proclaim Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our towns and cities, that they pay attention to the Christ message this Easter and receive it with joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nurses and doctors, that they continue to serve and heal in freedom of conscience, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those who cannot accept the spirit of truth, that their hearts be converted, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we love Christ and sanctify him as Lord in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Bob and Jalene Wigard, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, accept all our petitions and prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Błogosławiony jesteś, Panie Boże Wszechświata, bo dzięki Twojej hojności otrzymaliśmy chleb, który jest owocem ziemi i pracy rąk ludzkich. Tobie go przynosimy, aby stał się dla nas chlebem życia. Błogosławiony jesteś, Boże, teraz i na wieki. Błogosławiony jesteś, Panie Boże Wszechświata, bo dzięki Twojej hojności otrzymaliśmy wino, które jest owocem winnego krzewu i pracy rąk ludzkich. Tobie je przynosimy, aby stało się dla nas napojem duchowym. Dziękujemy Tobie, Boże, nasz Ojcze, bo Ty nas stworzyłeś, abyśmy żyli dla Ciebie i kochali się wzajemnie. Dzięki Tobie możemy się spotkać i rozmawiać ze sobą, dzielić się naszymi radościami i smutkami. Ojcze, cieszymy się z Twoich darów i składamy Ci dziękczynienie. Razem ze wszystkimi, którzy w Ciebie wierzą, z aniołami świętymi wychwalamy Ciebie. Prawdziwy i święty jesteś, Boże, i dobry dla wszystkich ludzi. Dzięki Ci składamy za Twojego Syna, Jezusa Chrystusa. On przyszedł na świat, gdy ludzie odwrócili się od Ciebie i nie żyli w zgodzie. On nas obdarzył światłem Ducha Świętego, abyśmy zrozumieli, że Ty jesteś naszym Ojcem, a my wszyscy jesteśmy braćmi i siostrami. Teraz Jezus gromadzi nas przy jednym stole, bo chce, abyśmy czynili to, co On uczynił. Najlepszy Ojcze, uświęć mocą Ducha Świętego te dary chleba i wina, aby się stały dla nas ciałem i krwią Twojego Syna, Jezusa Chrystusa. W czasie ostatniej wieczerzy, którą Pan Jezus przeżywał ze swoimi uczniami, zanim ofiarował się za nas na śmierć, wziął chleb. Dzięki Tobie składając, łamał i rozdawał swoim uczniom, mówiąc: bierzcie i jedzcie z tego wszyscy. To jest bowiem ciało moje, które za was będzie wydane. Podobnie wziął kielich napełniony winem, odmówił modlitwę dziękczynną i podał kielich swoim uczniom, mówiąc: bierzcie i pijcie z niego wszyscy. To jest bowiem kielich krwi mojej, nowego i wiecznego przymierza, która za was i za wielu będzie wydana na odpuszczenie grzechów. To czyńcie na moją pamiątkę. Spraw, abyśmy wszyscy z Chrystusem, z Najświętszą Maryją Panną, Matką Bożą i
ze wszystkimi świętymi, w szczególności ze świętym Janem Pawłem Wielkim, przebywali u Ciebie na wieki. Przez Chrystusa z Chrystusem i w Chrystusie, Tobie Boże Ojcze Wszechmogący, w jedności Ducha Świętego, wszelka cześć i chwała przez wszystkie wieki wieku. Wybaw nas, Panie, od zła wszelkiego i odnoś nasze czasy pokojem. Wspomóż nas w swoim miłosierdziu, abyśmy zawsze wolni od grzechu i bezpieczni od wszelkiego zamętu, pełni nadziei oczekiwali przyjścia naszego Zbawiciela, Jezusa Chrystusa. Bo Twoje jest królestwo i potęga i chwała na wieki. Panie Jezu Chryste, Ty powiedziałeś swoim apostołom: pokój Wam zostawiam, pokój mój Wam daję. Prosimy Cię, nie zważaj na grzechy nasze, lecz na wiarę swojego Kościoła i zgodnie z Twoją wolą napełnij Jego pokojem i doprowadź do pełnej jedności, który żyjesz i królujesz na wieki wieków.
Amen. Amen.
Pokój Pański niech zawsze będzie z Wami i z Duchem Twoim.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Oto Baranek Boży, który gładzi grzechy z świata, błogosławieni, którzy zostali wezwani na Jego ucztę. Panie, nie jestem godzien, abyś przyszedł do mnie, ale powiedz tylko słowo, a będzie uzdrowiona dusza moja.
Father Christ, amen. Father Christ, amen. Lord, this is on. Thank you.
of spiritual communion. Repeat after me. My Jesus, I believe that you,
I believe that you
are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you.
I love you.
Above all things. And I desire you. In my soul. Since I cannot. Now receive you sacramentally. Come at least. Spiritually into my heart. As though you were already there. I embrace you. And unite myself. Completely to you. Permit not. That I should ever. Be separated from you.
Be separated from you.
Amen.
Módlme się, Panie Boże, niech najświętszy sakrament, który przyjęliśmy w dzień świętego Jana Pawła II, udziela nam pomocy w życiu doczesnym i doprowadzi nas do radości wiecznej. Przez Chrystusa, Pana naszego.
Amen.
Pan z wami i z Duchem Twoim. Niech was błogosławi Bóg Wszechmogący, Ojciec i Syn i Duch Święty.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Idźcie w pokoju Chrystusa. Saint Michael, the
Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, rest into hell Satan
and all the evil spirits who wander about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Thank you all for joining us this morning for our wonderful Mass with our wonderful new priest, Father Kosk, who really isn't all that new anymore. It's been a week, so. But we thank him for the gift of Mass in Polish on this great feast of the Nativity of St. John Paul the Great, on this his 100th anniversary of his birth. So your homework today is to go either read something that he's written or to go look up his life and read more about his life story, because it is quite inspiring. God bless you all and happy Easter.